The question is, how can we forgive from our heart? Because at times we may say that we forgive and we also want to forgive, but we are we don't really feel that forgiveness inside the heart. Yes, actually sometimes when we speak words, the words are not insubstantial. The words are the beginning, but then from the words things have to move to the heart. So often by there are 2-3 different things which we could do regarding that specific relationship. You know, if we are not able to forgive in that relationship, often it happens that, you know, we feel that I have done so much for that person and that person has repaid me like this. Now, why should I forgive such a person? So if it is true that we have done a lot for that person and then that person has wronged us, then instead of looking at that relationship, we can look at some other relationships where we have been more of receivers than givers and where we have been forgiven. Now, as Jesus tells in the Bible that, you know, forgive others because God has forgiven you. So that way, by remembering that we are all wrongdoers in our own ways, and what to speak of our relationship with Krishna, even in our other relationships, there may be situations where we have been we have done wrong and others have forgiven us, although they had done a lot for us. So by thinking of it that way, we can say that, okay, there I was a recipient, so here let me be the giver, even if there is no reciprocation. So by that, basically the whole idea of emotional acceptance of things is essentially persuading the mind. Intellectually we understand something, but emotionally the mind doesn't accept. So we have to use different strategies for emotionally making the mind accept. So one of the strategies, what I discussed just now, is that we can try to think of other situations where we have been forgiven although we had done wrong. Second is that we can think broadly in terms of our relationship with Krishna and our spiritual advancement. So often when we don't forgive, then that person's actions and the memory of the hurt becomes like a mental glue that stays in our mind and heart. And not only does it hurt us, but even if the hurt decreases, still it distracts us from Krishna. So therefore, irrespective of that specific relationship, at least for the sake of our spiritual advancement, we know that we want to think about Krishna always. Now actually in one sense, love and hate can both be very similar, because love and hate are both very intense emotions. So if that residue of hatred is also there in our heart, then it can also occupy our mind the way we want love of Krishna to occupy our mind, to fill our mind with Krishna. So by letting that resentment go away, we will enable Krishna to enter into our heart and stay there. Now how do we do that? That may also, at one level it may be just by some mental exercises. Sometimes we can visualization, you know, okay, this feelings of resentment are like dirt that is sticking to the walls of our mind, and then we clean it and all that falls off. It just falls off, and then now we can just visualize it in the mind, and with a broom I sweep it away. And whenever, as Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur would say, that beat the mind. Now he would say, beat the mind in the morning, beat the mind in the evening. What does that beating the mind mean? It basically means getting the mind to get rid of its undesirable emotions, undesirable passions, undesirable agitations. So sometimes some mental visualizing exercises like this can also help. Another aspect is that, which is the most potent actually, if you can do it, is to, whenever the mind starts getting filled with those negative feelings towards others, is to absorb ourselves in some devotionally fulfilling activity. Now if we have some deities whose darshan we take with some photo on with some lamination that we have, or we have deities at home, or we have pictures on the computer. We pray to those deities, take darshan of those deities. Or there's some kirtan that we like to hear. We absorb ourselves in those devotional impressions. Or there are some very illuminating verses from scripture. So basically we absorb ourselves in Krishna, and by that way we drive away those feelings whenever they come. So in this way, by remembering that we have been forgiven by others, so we forgive. Or by remembering that this is what is best for our spiritual advancement, and therefore we visualize ourselves releasing those negativities and cleaning them away. Or we absorb ourselves in Krishna through devotional activities. That way we can internalize the external expressions of forgiveness. Thank you. Hare Krishna.